Hello Philippines and hello world. For today's video, we are going to tackle about the second law of thermodynamics. But before we formally start, allow me to introduce myself and my fellow colleagues. By the way, I am Ryan H. Ubon, and here are my fellow colleagues. Miss by Hanisa Karim, Miss Almira Gaya, Mr. Faisal Macarimbang, Mr. Nor Hashim, Mr. Norol Janalan, Mr. Amir Piang, and Mr. Sohel Escalipa.
Hello everyone, my name is Sohel Escalipa and I'm going to tackle about the origin of the second law of thermodynamics. The etymology of thermodynamics has an intricate history. American biophysicist Donald Heine claims that thermodynamics was coined in 1840 from the Greek root theme meaning heat and dynamis meaning power. The study of heat and its transformation into different forms of energy. One such scientist was Nicolas Leonard Sadi Carnot, the father of the thermodynamics, who in 1824 published Reflection of the Motive Power of Fire, a discourse on heat, power, and energy efficiency. This marks the start of thermodynamics as a modern science. The ancient viewed heat as that related to fire. In 3000 BC, the ancient Egyptian viewed heat as a related to origin mythologies. The ancient Indian philosophy, including Vedic philosophy, believed that five basic elements are the basis of all cosmic creation. In the Western philosophical tradition, after much debate about the primary elements among earlier pre-Socratic philosophers, Empedocles proposed the four-element theory, in which substances derived from earth, water, air, and fire. The Empedoclean element of fire is perhaps the principal ancestor of later concepts such as plug-in and caloric. Around 500 BC, the Greek philosopher Heraclitus became famous as the flash and fire philosopher for his proverbial utterance, "All things are falling." Heraclitus argued that the three principal elements in nature were fire, earth, and water.
What is thermodynamics? Thermodynamics can be simply stated as science of energy. Thermodynamics derived from the Greek word thermo and dynamics. Thermo means heat and dynamics means power. It is the branch of science that the relationship between heat, work, temperature, and energy. It deals with the transfer of energy from one place to another. The key concept is that heat is a form of energy corresponding to a definite amount of mechanical work.
The second law of thermodynamics says that the entropy of any isolated system always increases. Isolated systems spontaneously evolve towards thermal equilibrium, the state of maximum entropy of the system. More simply put, the entropy of the universe or the ultimate isolated system only increases and never decreases. A simple way to think of the second law of thermodynamics is that a room, if not clean and tidied, will invariably become more messy in disorderly with time, regardless of how careful one is to keep it clean. When the room is cleaned and its entropy decreases, but the effort to clean it has resulted in an increase in entropy outside the room that exceeds.
Nicolas Leonard Sadi Carnot was a French physicist who considered to be the father of thermodynamics. He is responsible for the roots of second law of thermodynamics, as well as numerous other principles. In several cases, the second law has been articulated. It's a first formulation which precedes the correct of entropy and was based on caloric theory. Caloric theory is the theorem of Carnot, attributed to the French scientist Sadi Carnot, who demonstrated in 1824 that there is an upper limit on efficiency of the heat transfer to operate in heat engine, the first systematic definition of the second law based.
Second law of thermodynamics. the difference between the first law. The first law of thermodynamics states that the energy cannot be created or destroyed. The total quantity of energy in the universe stays the same. The second law of thermodynamics is about quality of energy. It states that as energy is transferred or transformed, more and more of its waste. The first law, also known as law of conservation of energy, states that energy cannot be created or destroyed in isolated system. The second law of thermodynamics states that the entropy of any isolated system always increases.
Example of second law of thermodynamics. When a diesel engine turns generator, the engine mechanical energy is converted into electricity. The electricity is still pretty concentrated, but not all of the mechanical energy is converted to electricity. Some of the energy leaks away through friction and heat, and also used to determine the theoretical limits for the performance of mostly used engineering systems like heat engines and heat pumps.
Good day everyone. Today I will share the example of second law of thermodynamics. But I want to introduce myself first. I am Amir Pia. The best example of second law of thermodynamics is when a hot object is placed in contact with a cold object. It flows from the hotter one to the colder one, never spontaneously from colder to hotter. If it were to leave the colder object and pass to the hotter one, energy could still be conserved. Thank you.